Bună seara, doamnelor și domnilor, și bun găsit la o nouă emisiune, ediție specială. În această seară, invitații mei vin direct din America, pe filiera Universității Danubius. Vorbim de domnul prorector Steve O'Michael de la Universitatea Charles R. Drew din Los Angeles, USA, și de fiica lui Mareda Michael, care este în acest moment elevă în clasa a 10-a, tot în Los Angeles, USA. Vom avea în această seară traducere pentru răspunsurile pe care ni le dau invitații noștri, pentru că, evident, dumnealor se va exprima în engleză. Haideți să vedem care sunt diferențele principale între sistemul de învățământ american și cel românesc.
Which are the main differences between the Romanian and American educational system?
Yes.
Yeah, I just want to start by saying bună ziua. I've been coming to Romania for some time and I enjoy my visit to Romania. So I want to thank you for the opportunity to share some thoughts about American higher education system. And I have Mareda Michael, who is going to talk about the high school experience, and I can also talk about the college system.
Yes.
So I wonder if Mareda Michael, if you want to...
We need both point of views.
All right.
Please.
So coming from a high school point of view, I think I get a closer look at what it is, what the differences are between Romanian high schools and American high schools, and I had the pleasure of going to a few different Romanian high schools while I have been here for this week. And one of the main differences that I think I talked about at the schools and during my presentation and now here is that in America, you're allowed to have freedom to choose what type of classes you want to take in high school. So typically, you're allowed to choose what classes you want to take in college or in university. But in high school, they give you much more freedom. So you're allowed to, if you like math more, you're allowed to take more math classes. If you like art more, you can take more art classes. Whatever you like more, you can start to shift your focus to that specific subject. And I think that's one of the biggest differences, because in the Romanian high schools that I visited, they're kind of pushed into certain classes that they have to take to graduate. And that's not specifically the way that it is in the United States.
And now let's hear your answer in Romania, Mareda.
Oh.
Deci, una dintre cele mai mari diferențe dintre sistemul de învățământ din România și cel din Statele Unite este că, la nivel liceal, elevii din Statele Unite au posibilitatea de a-și alege materiile pe care preferă să le învețe. Adică, dacă sunt mai buni la matematică, ei își pot alege să facă un număr mai mare de ore la matematică. Dacă preferă științele, pot alege un număr mai mare de ore la științe și așa mai departe.
Is this system, the American system, affecting, I don't know, the general knowledge of the high school student in the end? Because, you know, you're choosing, but you're choosing some, how many...
Well, you have a few mandatory classes that you have to take to graduate, as it is here, but you're given freedoms to choose what type of languages, what type of math, what type of sciences, whichever is more to your interest. So you can choose maybe three or four different classes that are pertaining to what you enjoy.
Yeah, in my own opinion, I think the major difference that I've seen around the world is, you know, we have some systems that provide breadth of curricular experiences. So it's wider in terms of the breadth of experiences of students. They can take a wide variety of courses. Yeah. And then there is another system where students are kind of restricted and they try to go deeper within the curricula that is chosen, or they have chosen, or is chosen for them. So you have, on the one hand, you have people who are systems that enable you to experience a lot of things, you know, and electives. based on your passion and interest. And then you have the other experience where it is kind of restricted. Now, which one is better? Certainly there are some systems where the high school students, when they complete, they know so much about that narrow area. And then there are other systems where they know so much about so many things. Now, if the economy is changing fast and new jobs are going to be created, and the society is dynamic, breadth tends to be advantageous. Because if you are educated broadly, it is easier for you to adapt to the changes in the economy, in society, than if you are educated in a very narrow but deeper curricular path. So that's what I would say in general.
Yes, we are threatened by shallowness, I guess, knowing so much about so many.
Well, yeah, I guess you can say that, but it's not. I'm not saying one system is actually better than the other.
They are different.
These are different ways of looking, at educational experiences for young people. Do you introduce them to, for example, in United States, we also have students that get into sports. All right. It's not just one sport that is chosen for them. They do a number, variety of things, broadly speaking, in order to move toward a total human development. And through that, somehow you find your own passion as you go on. But if you know so much about so little, if that little becomes irrelevant, then you are in trouble.
Yes, nice point of view. Yeah. Let's hear the translation of our discussion.
Deci în America există posibilitatea de a-și alege obiectele de studiu, fiecare în funcție de ce preferă, astfel studiind mai multe lucruri. Ei sunt capabili să se adapteze la diferite schimbări ale societății și astfel își pot găsi adevărata pasiune, pot să descopere lucrurile pe care le iubesc într-adevăr. Nu putem spune că există, că sistemul de învățământ american este mai bun, sunt doar moduri diferite de a percepe lucrurile. Studenții americani au libertatea de a alege mai mult ca studenții noștri.
Ok, acum avem o întrebare pentru Mareda Michael. Simte că s-ar putea adapta vreodată la sistemul românesc de învățământ?
Mareda, do you think you could adapt to the Romanian educational system?
I think that I would be able to. I think it would take a little bit of time, but I think I would definitely be able to. I got asked this question from students that I was able to talk to earlier, and they didn't think that I would be able to, coming from America. But I think if I learned the language, I think language is the most important key to to communication. And translation is not always the easiest when you don't know how to communicate with the people there. So I think if I fully learned the language and I understood the customs and traditions, then I would be able to adapt to.
Acum să vedem traducerea.
Am primit această întrebare de la mulți elevi din România. Cred că m-aș putea adapta la acest sistem de învățământ. Singura problemă ar fi să învăț limba, să încep să cunosc tradițiile, obiceiurile din România, dar cu siguranță m-aș putea adapta la acest sistem.
În ceea ce îi privește pe studenții de la Danubius, domnule prorector, ce observați la ei? Este acea deschidere la care vă așteptați, acea capacitate de adaptare la schimbările care se întâmplă în jurul nostru? Sau, din contră, avem, într-adevăr, ne întâlnim cu zona aceasta a superficialității pentru că tratăm prea multe obiecte, prea multe materii odată.
Concerning the Danubius students, what do you think? Do they have the possibility of adapting themselves to the American educational systems, or they are too superficial?
Well, American higher education system is, in my opinion, one of the most flexible systems you have in the world. And because of that, it's actually quite easier for students all over the world to come to United States for further education, for graduate education. And this is why I think you probably have the largest number of international students studying in the United States from all over the world. It is because the system itself is very flexible. We do know that students that come in with less English language skills get into English as a second language, for example, to brush up their English. And if there are need for remediation, that is to say that their education is not at par, most institutions will provide remediation for them. They are assigned advisors that will speak to them one-on-one and help to guide them. Certainly Danubian students will be able to adapt and actually flourish. Most international students are driven because they know why they came to school. There may be a sense in which you have American kids that they take things for granted, but most international institutions are driven, they are focused, they know they are paying for that, and they know that they've come so far to chase after that degree. So I tend to see them as being more dedicated, studious, and focused on their work. Certainly, Danubian students will be able to flourish.
Yes, please, the translation.
Cu siguranță, studenții de la Danubius s-ar putea adapta la sistemul de educație american, deoarece este un sistem de educație flexibil și este ușor pentru toți studenții internaționali să se adapteze. Există posibilitatea ca ei să ia cursuri în care limba engleză să fie studiată ca o a doua limbă. Există de asemenea instituții speciale care ajută, au consilieri care fac acest lucru pentru ei. Deci, cu siguranță, nu ar fi o problemă adaptarea la sistemul american.
Oferta educațională din America la nivel academic este profund adaptată la ceea ce are piața nevoie, la ceea ce poate absorbi piața. Se întâmplă același lucru și în Galați, România?
I think that the American educational system is very adapted at the market needs. Do you think there is the same thing here in Romania and especially in Galați?
Mm-hmm. Well, as I said at the beginning, I'm not too sure that I know enough about the Romanian higher education system.
It's not your first time.
That's true. I have been here many times and many yes. years, and I love coming back. But I don't want to pretend to be an expert. But I would tell you that the beauty of private institutions in the United States is that they are market-driven, because without these institutions being responsive to the market, it will be difficult for them to survive. Private institutions in the United States operate within a very competitive market environment. So they have to identify kind of courses or academic programs that they need to offer. They must make sure that they are able to attract students that will come into those programs, graduate those students, make sure they are able to get jobs, all right, in order for them to continue on and continue to monitor the changes in the profession so that they can continue to change and adapt their curricular experiences for students. And if there are certain areas that have been discontinued, those programs are discontinued in order to make room for new ones. So the market drives everything that they do, especially in private universities.
Thank you, sir.
deși a avut oarecare experiență la nivel universitar aici în Galați, profesorul Steve Michael nu se pronunță în ceea ce privește situația de aici. În schimb, ar vrea să menționeze faptul că în Statele Unite ale Americii, universitățile particulare au un număr mare de programe de studiu care atrag studenții. Ei, când în momentul în care termină aceste universități, sunt capabili să-și găsească locuri de muncă adaptate la cererea pieței. Așa că sistemul de educație american asigură într-adevăr un număr de locuri suficiente pentru ca și un număr de programe suficiente pe care studenții să le urmeze și să-și poată găsi un loc pe piața muncii.
Mareta, liceenii din America sunt impulsionați să învețe în fiecare zi pe care o au la dispoziție și calificativele pe care le primesc toate sunt contabilizate la sfârșit și înțeleg că pe undeva contează și examenele finale. La noi se intră pe bază de dosar, la noi se intră mult mai ușor în sistemul universitar. Cum vezi acest lucru? Este o provocare la fel de mare pentru liceanul român și tocească coatele pe manuale ca pentru cel american?
So you have very difficult exams in order to get an entrance examination at a university. Here in Romania things are much more easier. I think our students don't have to give very difficult, very tough exam in order to get an entrance examination at a university. How do you see this thing?
I would say that in the United States you do have to take very difficult exams to get into the university, and specifically the SATs or ACTs. Yes. Both of those, either of them are necessary to get into universities, and you have to study a lot to get a high score on those. But I would say that Romanians, they do work very, very hard in their high schools, and you can tell in the way that they talk, in the way that they act, and the way that they think about their education. If they want to further their education in universities, then you can hear that in their attitudes, and you can see that in the way that they respect their work. I think that they work hard and they try their best, and I can't say that the education and the tests are exactly equal on both sides, Romanian and American, but I do believe that on both sides there are people that work hard and there are people that fall behind. So I wouldn't say that one of our tests is more difficult than any other one. I would say that the curriculum that we're learning is very pertaining to where we're from and the things that we are expected to know.
Okay, thank you.
Nu aș spune că este mai dificil examenul de admitere la universitate din Statele Unite ale Americii față de examenul de admitere la universitate din România. În ceea ce mă privește, am întâlnit mulți elevi de liceu din România. Consider că îi acordă un mare interes învățăturii și procesului de învățământ. Cred că ar fi ușor să se adapteze în orice parte. Ceea ce face diferența între cele două sisteme de învățământ sunt obiectele, materiile din curriculum.
Întrebarea care urmează se adresează domnului prorector. Este acest sistem extraordinar al burselor pe care le acordă universitățile americane. Ești un privilegiat dacă reușești să accesezi o asemenea bursă. Bineînțeles, anii de studiu și calificativele înalte te califică pentru o asemenea șansă. În România, conceptul de bursă este quasi inexistent. Putem face ceva în această direcție?
So it's very hard to get a scholarship in the United States. In Romania, this concept is almost non-existent. Can you do something in this direction?
So what you mean is that in Romania there are no scholarships because students don't pay?
No, students are paying, but they are not not allowed. It's not the system that allows scholarships.
Okay, right. Well, in United States, the desire of our society is to provide higher education experience for as many kids as possible, because we do know that education is critical not only for our nation's advancement, but individual advancement within our society. Hence, we want to make sure that finance is not the only reason why they are not accessing higher education. So what we are doing about that is, number one, to make college affordable. To make college affordable means we work very hard to make sure that the tuition that we charge is not outrageously out of reach for the majority of American students. That's number one. Number two, we also make sure that we provide scholarships, specifically two types of scholarship for American kids. Number one is what we call the merit-based scholarship. That means if you work very hard in American system and maintain high grades, have diverse experiences, get excellent recommendations from your teachers and principals, the chances of you getting merit scholarship is much higher. The second one is called need-based scholarship. Need-based scholarship is based on your social economic status, the income of your parents, and your resources. So the lower your social economic status, and the fewer the resources at your disposal, the more likely you will get need-based scholarship, especially if your grades are good. And you also, you know, will be able to access scholarship to the extent that you have excellent grades in many, many universities in the United States. So tuitions are high, but we look for ways to reduce the burden on students, and we work very hard to keep tuition fees affordable.
Thank you. Waiting.
Deci, educația este importantă la nivelul societății, iar sistemul de educație american încearcă să facă acest lucru, deci să facă educația permisivă, adică elevii să-și poată permite. Să
Să acceseze,
să intre la o universitate particulară. Există două tipuri de burse, bursele de merit pentru elevii care au recomandări și note excelente și bursele sociale care depind de venitul părinților, de resursele părinților. De asemenea, taxele de admitere la universitățile particulare sunt în anumite limite
pentru ca
ele să fie accesibile, pentru ca elevii, studenții să-și permită acest lucru.
Întrebarea mea de final se adresează amândurora și, lăsând la o parte sistemele educaționale, ne dăm seama oricum că sunt diferențe majore între cel american și cel românesc. Vreau să vă întreb despre șocul cultural. Primele lucruri pe care le-ați simțit în momentul în care ați întâlnit România sub forma diverselor persoane cu care v-ați întâlnit în mediile academice sau pe stradă?
What about the cultural shock? Have you felt this when you first came here in Romania?
It's for both of you.
I know, referring about the people, the persons you have met.
One of the biggest differences for me is the greeting. So we don't usually do the greeting that you do here. We don't do that in the United States.
What kind of greeting do you mean?
When you shake and then you kiss on both cheeks. Yeah, we don't do that in America. We'll just shake hands. So that was the biggest difference for me. But I mean, it's just part of the culture, so I was able to like pick that up very quickly and understand. But other than that, like
the Russians do it three times. The kissing. So we are modest.
So that's just one of the biggest like cultural differences for me. But other than that, besides like the differences in food and drinks and things like that, like everything is very similar to the United States. So
please, the translation.
Prima diferență pe care a sesizat-o a fost atunci când oamenii o salutau, deoarece unii dădeau mâna sau o sărutau pe obraj. Ei nu au lucrul acesta în Statele Unite, dar a înțeles că este o parte a culturii noastre și s-a adaptat. O altă diferență culturală este cea în ceea ce privește mâncarea, băutura, care sunt diferite aici.
How about you, sir?
Well, I have had the opportunity of coming to Romania for so many years.
So you alluded to the cultural shock.
I have many good friends here. Yeah, I have friends at Danubio University, and the faculty and the leadership. And one thing is, I have been traveling around the world since I was little. One of the reasons why I bring Marita Michael along with me on this travel is for her to get to know the world and begin to appreciate people and to realize that the differences among us are very few and the similarities among all of us are great, and that all of us belong to the same family of humanity. You know? And once you do that, it reduces any cultural shock that can be there. Okay, so you eat mamaliga, right?
Yeah,
all right,
sure.
All right, and you know, so
it has. Good? Do you like it?
It has a different taste. But one can
how
get used to it.
How do you call it in America?
It looks like porridge. grits. Yeah, okay, it looks like grits. You know, it's not hard enough to require a sauce, and it's not soft enough for us to drink it like cornflakes. So it's in between.
Yes.
So it makes
it's a conflicted concept to the mamaliga.
Right. How to eat it requires some skills to do that. And also, you know, there are quite a number of a lot of consumption of real meat.
Yeah.
That's generally barbecued. All those things are, you know, but you know, it is really great. But above all, the friendship of the people that we have, you know, maybe I can stop now.
Yes, let's hear.
All right. So, I'm sorry.
Deci, domnul profesor a avut posibilitatea de a veni în România de mai multe ori, deoarece are legături cu Universitatea Danubius. Spune că a călătorit foarte mult timp, dar aceasta a fost o oportunitate pentru el să aprecieze oamenii și culturile diferitelor popoare. De fapt, el consideră că odată ce a avut posibilitatea să cunoască românii și a dat seama că diferențele nu sunt multe, pentru că de fapt cu toții suntem oameni, și aceasta l-a ajutat să reducă șocul cultural pe care l-a avut. Și de asemenea menționează anumite diferențe la nivel
de mâncare tradițională.
La nivelul mâncării tradiționale, cum ar fi mămăliga, pe care o
avem. Nici nu bei, nici nu mănânci foarte clar, da? E undeva între.
Da, dar spune că prietenia pe care a legat-o aici cu diferiți oameni l-a ajutat să depășească bariera diferențelor culturale.
There are so many things that we could talk about from now on, but this is the space located for our show. So thank you very much for coming here and coming so often in Galați. We need your experience and yours too, Mareda. Thank you.
Thank
and
you.
Now I will talk in Romanian for our viewers.
La revedere.
Yes. Doamnelor și domnilor, aceasta a fost emisiunea noastră din această seară. Vă mulțumesc pentru atenție și să aveți seară frumoasă în continuare. La revedere.